Timmy. I'm really happy that today we are starting our next workshop for incorporating universal human values in education. And in this workshop, we have our friends from Bhutan also participating in it. And I'm happy that Professor Prema Thinleji, who is the former Vice Chancellor of Royal University of Bhutan, is also present in this inaugural session. This whole effort, which Professor Anil Sahasrabuddhiji was referring, it is in the lines of National Education Policy, which was announced last year in the country, and regarding aspirations which have been mentioned in this national policy, this whole effort of universal human values is in the line of those aspirations of National Education Policy. When we see our National Education Policy, we see that the expectations from education are: education is fundamental for achieving full human potential, developing an equitable and just society, and promoting national development. Now, in order to go ahead, we need to understand about the meaning of these three aspirations or these three expectations from education: full human potential, equitable and just society, and national development. When we talk about full human potential, that means at the level of individual, human being must be happy at the conscious level as well as prosperous for his or her needs for the body also. That means happiness and prosperity both are needs of human beings, and not only it is for some time, but it is a continuous need of each and every human being, happiness and prosperity. And at the level of society, everyone needs right understanding and right feeling to have continuous happiness in their life. It is at the level of every individual. And at the level of every family, there must be prosperity in the family. That means they must have the feeling of having more than as per their requirements for the family. And third is, in the society, there must be fearlessness at all levels. That means there must be feeling of trust with each other in the society. And at the level of nature and existence, we must have a feeling of coexistence, that is the mutual fulfillment of the nature as well as of the human beings. So then only we can say that it is equitable and just society. And in the absence of any of these elements, any of these four elements, we cannot have equitable and just society. And when we say promoting national development, that means at the level of nation, there must be harmony within the nation, and the nation must be able to be complementary to other nations. That means to support them, to help them to have harmony within themselves. So this is the details of these three aspirations from education and the National Education Policy. So National Education Policy articulates these basic human aspirations. The expectation from education is to prepare people competent to fulfill these aspirations. So we have to understand this whole effort of universal human values in this light of basic human aspiration. Next. Now, when we see how to realize these basic human aspirations, which have been articulated in National Education Policy, it can be realized through humane education and sanskar. Through education and sanskar, we have humane world vision. That means how we see the world around, in which perspective we see the world around. On the basis of our perspective or our vision, we develop human values. That means what is valuable for us and what is not valuable for us. That makes human values for us, and we need skills to live as per our vision and as per our values. That means as per our human conduct, we need skills so that we can have a value-based life in our life. So then only we can say that we are realizing full human potential. Without values, without world vision, and without skills, we cannot think of full human potential. The graduates who are competent to contribute to a human society, culture, and civilization, they will be able to have an equitable and just society. And this society is not only in the neighborhood, but it is at all levels, in neighborhood, in village, block, society, district, state, etc. And then such society results into national development. That means a nation having harmony within itself and harmony with other nations and complementary to other nations. So that is called human society, human culture, human civilization. Now, in today's case, the missing link is this world vision and human values. So because of that, we are unable to provide right kind of skills which are helpful for value-based living. So, and due to this missing link, we are unable to have equitable and just society, or we are unable to have a developed nation around us. So this effort of universal human values is working on these three steps. First is universal human values. That means those values which are universal in nature. We might have learned from our teachers, our parents, our forefathers, but these values are applicable to in every nation, in every part of the world, Asia, Australia, America, Africa, Europe, in any part of the world. And these values are rational in nature. That means we can understand it and we can discuss it with our students. We can have right kind of dialogue with our students. These are rational in nature. And these are verifiable also. That means if we live as per those values, we get the desired results. So we can experientially verify these values. These are all encompassing. They deal with our thoughts, they deal with our behavior, they deal with our actions, they deal with our realization. And at the same time, it leads to harmony at all levels. That means at the level of self, it resolves all the contradictions within ourselves, and it leads to harmony in family, leads to harmony in society, and leads to harmony in the nature. In this whole effort, we also take care of in our induction program case studies from Indian knowledge system. That means the case studies from our own tradition, so that students can relate those traditions, relate those actions, whatever is happening around them, with those universal values. So these are result of that effort for human culture over thousands of years. And then third is, based on those values, those value-guided skills, education and practice is required. That means the skills which are nature-friendly and which are people-friendly. So such skills, if we have, then the competent graduates will come out from the colleges, and these competent people will be able to contribute to a human society, culture and civilization. That means an equitable and just society and national development. Next. So our focus is on the value component, which is the crucial missing link in present-day mainstream education. If we are able to ensure it, the education on skills will be properly placed. We will be able to make right utilization of the skills. And two things will happen. The full development of human personality will begin to be realized. Such people will have the mindset and skills both to develop the foundations of a society which is equitable and just, which will lead to national development. It means the aspirations articulated in National Education Policy 2020 will be fulfilled. So this whole effort is in realizing those basic aspirations of human beings. In mainstream education, this need has been felt for a long time. So the need for reform in mainstream education, particularly inculcation of values, has been felt for quite a while. The issue had been about how to go about it. How to go about it in a manner which is acceptable to every human being in all places and at all times. So then only we can have right kind of value education in our society. Next. When we talk about value component in mainstream education, then there are so many issues which come up for discussion. So I'll deal with those questions. One is, without right values, we cannot have right use of skills. If we have right values, then only we will have right use of skills. Otherwise, with wrong values, we will have misuse of skills. And with even more skills, the faster and more pervasive right use of skills with right values. And on the other hand side, faster and more pervasive misuse of skills with the wrong values. Now we have to think, where are we today? Are we having right kind of values in our schools and colleges or not? Now when we talk about having these value education in our schools and colleges, so many people have misconception that values cannot be taught, they are caught. Of course, values are inspired and reinforced in institutions by people who are living models of human values. From the experiments in the last 15 years in mainstream education, it is clear that human values can be taught. Youth, regardless of their background, find it interesting when it is shared as a proposal rather than a set of instructions or do's or don'ts. They are able to explore into proposals, discover the values intrinsic in them. The self-exploration is an effective means of self-evolution. This is significant perceptual transformation in those exploring seriously. We have found with those youth who are dealing with it seriously. In general, what we find that while going for this value education in our families, our parents, they emphasize on doing part of it. That means regarding behavior and work of children. They try to discipline them through instructions. That means externally enforced fear or incentive, fear of punishment or incentive of some price. But we know that through this kind of discipline effort, the conduct is not definite. It is still indefinite. Then we try to focus on their thinking. We try to give them some ideas, some morals. This kind of moral education is mainly based on belief. And we find that this kind of moral education also does not result in definite conduct. And the conduct is still indefinite. And current effort of value education, we focus on understanding part of it. Understanding of what? Understanding of definite, universal, invariant values and right worldview and right perspective. And this kind of value education is put before the students as proposals. They are encouraged to have self-exploration within themselves. And they are encouraged to know it at their own right. And this results into self-discipline because it is based on their natural acceptance. So that's how this current effort of value education and its outcome is that their conduct becomes definite for their future life. So then people say that, is it too late? We have accumulated so many problems at every level, at the level of individual, at the level of family, at the level of society, at the level of nature. So if we can start it from now, from where should we start? Where to start? Teachers or parents or policymakers? At what level to start in education? Primary or secondary or higher education? It's good to start value education right from elementary stage. Children start learning values right from childhood, in their homes, from their parents. So it's better to start from their parents. But when we go to educate the parents, ultimately we have to work with grown-ups. So why not start with the higher education? Through higher education, we are directly able to address the future teachers, parents, and policy makers. So that is the reason that we are making effort in higher education currently. And these efforts had encouraging results for all of us. This effort of realization of truth, love, and compassion. We know all great people of the world have tried to realize the truth and to live by it in terms of love and compassion. They have tried to do two things. One, to understand themselves. That means to understand human beings, to understand the underlying harmony in nature, in existence. They have tried to understand the role of the human being in nature, in existence, to live by it, and to develop an equitable and just society. For all such great people, we have a deep feeling of gratitude. This effort on universal human values is in continuation with that tradition of self-inquiry for the well-being of all. Here, the purpose is well-being of all, and the process is self-exploration, self-inquiry. It is not imposition. It is not through punishment or through rewards. So drawing upon universal essence, it is put forth as proposals for self-exploration on one's own right. So that is the purpose and the process of this whole effort. Universal human values has been experimented in the last 40 years. So with the people from all walks of life, children, families, youth, in higher education, urban people, criminals in jail, politicians, administrators, social workers, NGOs, farmers, Adivasis, etc., etc. It has been rigorously experimented in mainstream education over the last 15 years, starting with one college to over 4,000 colleges with very encouraging results. We feel that it is a workable process proposal with a significant potential. It can be used as a starting point for further developing a universal framework for incorporating values in mainstream education and living. You are the custodians of education in the nation. We invite you to participate, to explore the content, to explore the process, and draw your own conclusion. When I was Vice Chancellor at Punjab Technical University, I am happy to share that we introduced the foundation course on universal human values in the first and second semester for all students of Punjab Technical University. We established an international resource center for universal human values at Punjab Technical University. We started PG diploma in universal human values after graduation, and M.Tech program in holistic development systems and technologies after B.Tech in any discipline. I'm happy to share that those batches, those who undergo these courses, PG diploma and M.Tech, we had 100% placement for that. That doesn't mean that there was any campus recruitment, etc. But 100% placement means all of them had developed the self-confidence to independently find meaningful ways to live their life happily. So that's how that effort had very encouraging results. So there had been many efforts in various parts of the country. In 1980, a course on science and humanism at IIT Delhi was started. In 2001, MHRD, Ministry of Human Resource Development, now it is Ministry of Education, established National Resource Center in Value Education at IIT Delhi, NCERT, and IIM Lucknow. 2005, IIIT Hyderabad experimented with mandatory two-semester course on universal human values. 2009, UP Technical University scaled it up to 550 affiliated colleges. 2011 in Punjab Technical University, we rapidly scaled it up. 2012, it was started in Bhutan also. And it deeply resonates with their national program of gross national happiness. And we have our friends participating in this workshop also from Bhutan. And in 2012 itself, the HPD Technical University also, Himachal Pradesh Technical University also adopted it in their curriculum. And then Bikaner Technical University really did rapid implementation of this Universal Human Values program. Today, in 2021, in more than 40 universities in 10 states of India have the UHV Foundation course as a core part of their academic curriculum. So these were the efforts which had been there in previous years. And the induction program, which now by AICT in all engineering colleges, it is the first 3 weeks for all the first year students. It actually started in 2011 in IIT Gandhinagar, when they started 5 week induction program for creating well-rounded personality. In 2013, NIT Trichy followed IIT Gandhinagar model with 3 week induction program. In 2016, IITs also accepted this model, a 5 week program for UG students in the IIT system. And 2016 itself, three IITs, IIT BHU, IIT Mandi, and IIT Patna, they started 3 week induction program in their curriculum. Here, we can say from all these experiments, it is clear that human values can be taught. And second is, problems are largely as a result of the lack of human values, and not only for the lack of skills. So we have to focus on both values as well as skills. Universal human values can be used as starting point for further developing a universal framework for incorporating values in mainstream education. Next. AICT has adopted this universal human values approach for value inculcation in 2017, when they decided to update its model curriculum from 2018-19 academic year for all technical education, engineering, architecture, etc. across India. So they did two things. One, universal human values was included as a core part of the mandatory student induction program and as UHV1. And it is to be offered as an essential 3-credit course as UHV2 in third or fourth semester or earlier. Today, more than 10,000 colleges under the AICT umbrella are preparing their teachers for this huge task of human national importance. So this is what the initiative of AICT, and they have made tangible efforts for human values in technical education. At the policy level, they started induction program cell under the leadership of Deputy Director Officer Dr. Neetu Bhagatji at AICT headquarters. And then they introduced this UHV1, UHV2 in model curriculum. And now from last year, in their approval process handbook, they have mentioned about universal human values. They ask all the colleges when they come to AICT for further approvals that whether they have trained their teachers for teaching universal human values in their course. And AICT is also enabling faculty development programs throughout the year for orientation and training of teachers for teaching these courses of UHV1, UHV2. They provide certificates to successful candidates. And they also recognize the individual faculty members, colleges, and universities who are making efforts in this direction of UHV. Next. Friends, this is an initial but significant step of AICT in value-based education for value-based living, which includes sustainable planet-friendly technology and humane planet-friendly management practices. Steps for preparing faculty for these programs will be outlined on the last day. How to go further, we'll discuss it in the last day of this workshop. So this is the page of approval process handbook. I have also already discussed it with you. And this is a letter from AICT to all the technical universities or the other universities to add it to their curriculum for the students of all affiliated colleges. This 3-credit course is there in the model curriculum. Next. It is mandatory course. So objectives of induction program, which is 3 weeks induction program, it is that new entrants go through years of stirrness preparation and get accustomed to it in their 11th and 12th classes. Often they lose the connection from social life and recreational activities. On the other hand, engineering demands a personality in all dimensions, not only engineering, but in every professional institution, in any course in the technical education. So induction program is designed for smooth transition from preparation environment to engineering or professional curriculum. So this induction program is initially for 21 days. Then there is a continuity in the remaining 4 years through student activity cells. Next. So the approach of student induction program activities is universal approach. All the SIP activities modules are based on generic and universal principles. Local, regional, national, and international examples are taken so that students can relate them to their day-to-day life. For example, we want to live with fulfillment as a society. This part is common and universal. This is common to all nationalities, to all religions, to all regions. To exemplify this, we may expose students to traditional Indian culture and philosophy, as well as contemporary Western culture and thought. In this way, it will help in connecting the basic principles through specific examples. It will help the students to see and appreciate various cultures, to see the commonality amongst them in the light of clarity about human culture and civilization. It will help to evaluate any specific example, system, or culture with a view to fill the gap rather than to criticize or reject it. Further, we can also be mutually enriching for other cultures. So that's how the students are exposed to these universal principles, so that when they see these any kind of gap, instead of criticizing that gap, instead of rejecting the gap, they feel the responsibility to fulfill that gap in their life. This 3-credit mandatory course has 2 objectives. One is development of a holistic perspective based on self-exploration about themselves, family, society, and nature, and development of the commitment and courage to act on their own right, so that they don't feel pressure from peer or from other sides of the society. We have developed a full-fledged syllabus for 1 semester 3-credit course, teacher's manual with 28 lecture plans, lectures and 14 practice sessions, textbook presentations, including practice sessions, tutorials and videos of workshop lectures. It is all available on website, 8-day faculty development program, and then it is followed by weekly meetings, those who are seriously interested to explore it further. So friends, I have shared with you the content and the process. Content is universal, rational, verifiable, all-encompassing, and leading to harmony. And the process is process of self-exploration. This will be sufficiently exemplified in the presentations in this workshop. Now, I invite all of you. You are the custodians of the future technical education in the nation. We look forward to your active participation. let us explore together and materialize the possibility. We trust it will help in further refining your view about this effort, its desirability, and its potential. And we look forward to hear from you about your commitment. Thank you. Thank you very much.